Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? I hope that you all are doing great. Welcome to your channel Maths D1D2 Scientific Academy. Okay, today our lecture is related to chapter 4, which is expansion and factorization of algebraic expression. I'm going to explain you exercise 4C and your book is New Syllabus Mathematics 2 D2 Maths. Okay, students, before starting the lecture, I would request you that if you want more help regarding your subject, then you can subscribe to the channel. Okay, जी, question number 2 is factorize each of the following expressions completely. Okay, जी, what we need to do is we have to factorize them. Okay, there are many methods to make the factors and to factorize the expressions. But students, if you find that if the first and the last term are the perfect squares, here you can see that this is the perfect square and you will take the square of m, you will get m square. And this is also the perfect square of 5 because when you will take the square of 5, you will get 25. So if you find that the first and the last term are the perfect squares, so then you can use this formula. Here you can see that here this is minus. So you can use the formula a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. So you can use this formula. Okay. What you need to remember is that first and the last term are the perfect squares. Okay, students, here you can see that the question is m square minus 10m plus 25. So now we are going to apply the formula, which is a square minus 2ab plus b square. So here the a is m. So a square, m is the square, a square minus 2 minus 2ab. So minus 2, a is m. Okay, students, what should be b that we can get 10m? Okay, when we will multiply 2 with m, we will get 2m. But we need 10m. So what should be b to get 10m? As here you can see that when you will multiply 2 with 5, then you will get 10. 2 5s are 10. 2 5s are 10. And when you will multiply 10 with m, you will get 10m. So it means that a is m and b is 5. So a square minus 2ab plus b square. B is 5. Now we have made the formula. Okay, what's the formula? A square minus 2ab plus b square. And as you can see that a square minus 2ab plus b square is equal to a minus b whole square. So now we are going to write this as a minus b whole square. So this is equal to a minus b whole square. Okay, students, I hope that part A is clear to you. Let's come to B part. Okay, when you'll see more sums, then this concept will be more clear to you. Okay, 169n square minus 52n and plus 4. So here you can see that this and this term are the perfect square. This is the perfect square of 13. When you will take the square of 13n, you will get 169n square. And this is the perfect square of 2. When you will take the square of 2, you will get 4. So first and the last term, you will see first and the last term, they are the perfect squares. We are going to use this formula. Okay, Jill. Now we are going to apply the formula. So in place of 169 n square, we can write 13 n whole square. And this is a. Now we are going to apply the formula, which is a square. A square. So instead of this, I will write 13 n whole square. In place of this, I can write this 13 n whole square, because when you will solve it, you will get 169 n square. So a square minus 2 a. Okay, students, now what should be b to get 52 n? Here you can see that when you multiply 2 with 13, you will get 26. And so when you will multiply 26 with 2, you will get 52. So it means that you have to multiply 26 with 2 to get 52. So it means that b is 2. 2 a b. Then you will get 52n. 2 multiply by 13 multiply by 2 is 52, and this is a variable n. When you multiply 52 with n, you will get 52n. Okay, a square minus 2 a b plus b square. So b is 2. So I will write 2 square. And same, when you will take the square of 2, you will get 4. So I have just solved this in this way. A square minus 2ab plus b square. So it means that this is the formula of a minus b whole square. Okay, students, I hope that part B is also clear to you. Now let's move forward to C part. Okay, ji. C part is 81 minus 80 P plus 100 P scale. Here, students, you can see that this and this are the perfect square. This is the perfect square of 9 and this is the perfect square of 10 P. When you take the square of 10 P, you will get 100 P square. So these and these are the perfect square, so you can apply this formula. So now A square, since in place of 81, you can write 9 square. A square minus 2A. Okay, so what should be B to get 80? Okay, ji. 2 9s are 18, and when you will multiply 18 with 10, so you will get 2 9s are 18, and this is 180 P, sorry. So you will get 180. And here the variable is P, so you will multiply with 10 P. 2 9s are 18, and when you will multiply 18 with 10, you will get 180. And when you will multiply 180 with P, you will get 180. Okay, it means B is 10P and A is 9. A square minus 2AB. So when we will solve this, we will get 180P plus B square. So B is 10P. And when you will take the square of 10P, you will get 100P square. So here we have formed the formula. A minus B whole square. As here you can see that A square minus 2AB plus B square. And this is equal to A minus B whole square. This is the formula that we have made. Okay, ji. Now let's move forward to D part. Okay, ji. D part is 49 Q square minus 42 QR. Plus 9R square. Okay, students, as here you can see that this and this are the perfect square. This is the perfect square of 7Q. 7 7s are 49, and this is the perfect square of 3R. 3 3s are 9. So these two are the perfect square, so we can apply this formula. Okay, ji. Now we are going to apply the formula. A square, A is, so in place of 49Q square, we can write 7Q whole square. So A square, because when you will take the square of 7q, you will get 49th q square. So a square minus 2ab. Okay, what should be b to get 42qr? 2 7s are 14, and when you will multiply 14 with 3, you will get 42. 2 7s are 14, and when you will multiply 14 with 3, you will get 42. So 3r. As q is there, so r is missing. So I will multiply with 3r. So 2 7s are 14, 14 3s are 42, and when I will multiply the variables q and r, I will get qr. So b is 3r, so I can write down 3r whole square. And here you can see that this is 9r square, so when I will take the square of 3r, I will get 9r square. So formula is made, a square minus 2ab plus b square. So this is equal to a minus b whole square. So your answer is 7q minus 3r whole square. Okay, students, I hope that this concept is clear to you. Okay, now let's move forward to question number 3. Okay, students, question number 3 is factorize each of the following expressions completely. And part A is s square minus 144. Okay, students, when you will take the square of 12, you will get 144. So in place of 144, you can write down 12. So this is s, I can write this as s whole square. Because when I will take the square of s, I will get s square. And in place of 144, 144 is the perfect square of 12. So I can write down 12 whole square. So in place of 144, I have written 12 whole square. And in place of s square, I have written s square. Now I will tell you that why I have written this in this form. Because you know the formula a square minus b square is equal to a plus b a minus b. So to make this formula, I have written these two terms like this. So this is a square minus b square. And you know that a square minus b square is equal to a plus b and a minus b. A square minus b square is equal to a plus b and a minus b. So this is your answer. And I hope that this is clear to you. Okay, what you need to remember in this question is, whenever you find that there is a minus sign and there are two terms and they are the perfect squares, so it means that over here you can apply this formula. And here you can see that 144 is the perfect square of 12. So I have written 12 square, and S square is the perfect square of S. So I have written S whole square. So A square minus B square. I have made the formula and I have applied it, which is equal to A plus B and A minus B. Okay. Now let's move forward to B part. B part is 36t square minus 25. Okay, here students, here you can see that 36 is the perfect square of 6. 6, 6 is 36. You can write 6t whole square. So in place of 36t square, you can write down 6t whole square, because 36 is the perfect square of 6. And t square means that you write down t and whole square. So, in place of 25, you can write down 5 whole square, because 25 is the perfect square of 5. So, you can write down 5 whole square. So, when you will take square of 60, you will get 36 t square, and when you will take the square of 5, you will get 25. So, you can write down these two terms like this, 60 whole square minus 5 square. And as I have told you the purpose, that why I have written this like in the form of square, because I have to make the formula a square minus b square. So this is a square minus b square, and it is equal to a plus b a minus b, and this is your answer. I hope that this is clear to you. Now let's move forward to C part. Okay, so 225 is the perfect square of 15. When you will multiply 15 with 15, you will get 225. So we can write down 15 whole square. In place of 225, you can write down 15 whole square. Is a perfect square of 15, and 49 is a perfect square of 7, so you can write down 7 u whole square. So a square minus b square. So here I can apply the formula a plus b and a minus b. Okay, gee. So 225 is a perfect square of 15, and 49 is a perfect square of 7. So this is a square and this is b square. I have applied the formula a plus b a minus b. Okay, now let's move forward to the last part. I hope that part is clear to you. The last part is 49w square minus 81x square. So students, 49 is the perfect square of 7. So I can write down 7w whole square. And minus 81 is the perfect square of 9. When you will multiply 9 with 9, you will get 81. 9 9s are 81. So 81 is the perfect square of 9. So I can write down 9x whole square. So now I have written these two terms like this, 7w whole square and 9x whole square. Because when I will take the square of 7w, I will get 49w square. And when I will take the square of 9x, I will get 81x square. So I have made the formula a square minus b square, and is equal to a plus b a minus b. Okay students, I hope that question number 3 is clear to you. This was very simple and easy. You just need to make the formula and you have to apply the formula. Okay, now I'm going to explain you question number 4. Okay students, question number 4 is, without using a calculator, evaluate each of the following. Okay, here you can see that there are two terms, and over there are squares, and in between there is a minus sign. So it means that over here we can apply the formula, which is equal to a square minus b square is equal to a plus b a minus b. Here you can see that this is a term, a square minus, and this is b term, b square. So a square minus b square is equal to a plus b and a minus b. So okay, a minus b. this was the formula a square minus b square, and you just have opened it, a plus b, a minus b. Okay students, now you will subtract 41 from 59, and what you will get? 59 and 41. When you will subtract 9 minus 1, it is 8, and 5 minus 4 is 1. So you will get 18. And when you will add 59 and 41, you will get 9 plus 1 is 10. 1 is the carry, and 5 plus 1 is 10. So it is 100. So when you will multiply 100 with 18, you will get 1800. So this is your answer. So this is how you have to solve the sums, and you will apply the formula because it's written that without using a calculator. So you will not directly take the square of 59 and 41 solve it. You will apply the formula like this: a square minus b square is equal to a plus b, and a minus b. You will solve it and you will get the answer. These two are adding, so when you will add, you will get 100, and these two are subtracting, so you will get 18. And here there is no sign between these two numbers, it means that they are multiplying. So when you will multiply 100 with 18, you will get 1800. Okay, so I hope that this is clear to you. Let's move forward to B part. Okay, so the formula is a square minus b square. So you can apply the formula a plus b and a minus b. Okay, so when you will add 2.3 and 7.7, what you will get? We are going to add it. 7, 8, 9, 10. 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10.0 means 10. And when you will subtract 2.3 from 7.7, now we are going to subtract it. When you will subtract 3 from 7, you will get 4. And when you will subtract 2 from 7, you will get 5. So you will get 5.4. So students, when you will multiply 10 with 5.4, you will get 54. When you will multiply 5.4 with 10, you will get 54. You can multiply in the rough work. Okay students, I hope that B part is also clear to you. And students, do the practice of these sums. I hope that today's lecture is clear to you. When you will do the practice, then this concept will be more clear to you. Memorize the formula and take very good care of yourself. Thank you very much, and Allah Hafiz.